guys, welcome to the vlog. So recently TikTok discovered I was from Texas. So I was inundated with HEB sponsorships on TikTok, which I didn't know was a thing, and I would love for HEB to sponsor me on TikTok. If you're not from Texas, you're probably thinking, why are you saying these three letters? HEB is like our Walmart. So now I have discovered the spicy Carolina Reaper cheese puffs from HEB. I got so many sponsored ads for these on TikTok, and clearly they worked because I added it to my HEB pickup order, and they're the Carolina Reaper pepper cheese puffs. So one of the TikToks, someone ate one and they were like, I'm done. Another one, a guy was eating them, he ate like seven, and then they showed him like on the floor. They smell good. They smell like Doritos. So let's do this. I'm afraid I'll block out the chewing. I know some of you guys hate that. This is what they look like, just a little Cheeto. They look very cheesy. I don't know how these are gonna be hot, but. It tastes kind of smoky. This was a fail. I thought these were gonna be so hot that I was gonna be like, but I'm not, but they're good. Suggest them. Editing Edyn here. Yes, I did just spend 5 minutes talking about knockoff Cheetos. On to the rest of the vlog. Hello, kind people. This is a top from Lola Gets. I actually got it last year, but I really love it, so I wanted to show you guys. And pants from Super Fit Hero. This morning, I actually had a lot to do, so I decided to do a walking at home video. I've been doing these videos for over 7 years, and I absolutely love them. A lot of people think that Leslie Sansone is just for old people, but it's a great low impact cardio workout, and it sounds like I'm just like riding hard for Leslie Sansone right now, but I am. I love her. She's just the sweetest ray of light. She's so empowering, and I love doing her workouts, especially if I'm running low on time or I just don't feel like doing a HIIT workout. It's nice to get your body moving. It's super heart healthy, and yeah. So this is actually just the warm-up portion of this workout that you guys are watching right now. I always post the full workouts on Instagram. So if you don't follow me on Instagram, here is my shameless plug. Me sticking my tongue out at the camera. Very mature, Edyn. To follow me on Instagram, because you get to see my workouts in real time there. I usually post them the day that I do them on Instagram, but some people requested that I add more of my fitness routine into either my What I Eat in a Days or my weekly vlogs. So I am trying to do that for you all. This is your daily reminder to make your workouts work for you. If you don't want to run, don't run. If you don't like dance, don't do dance, but find what you do love. I love these walking at home videos, even though they are like dated and not the coolest thing. I love them. I turn on music and I get my heart rate up, and some of them do get you pretty sweaty, like the boosted walks or the 5K walks. They're more challenging than you would think, and I just love them. I almost love them as equally as going outside and walking, which is actually what I plan to do today because it's the middle of October and it's 89 degrees and breezy, and I love that for us here in Austin. I needed to fuel my body, of course, and you know, the only fuel for me is an English muffin. So I have an English muffin with an egg, some cream cheese, some mixed greens and tomato, and oh my gosh, that was so yummy. I had my coffee with my ball mason jar lid, which you're supposed to use a straw, but I just use it like a sippy lid and it's totally fine, and some grapes. Does anyone else do this with their grapes? You take them all off of the vine. I feel like they last a really long time this way, and it's just super convenient to be able to grab a handful. I got this tilapia from Wheatsville Co-op. You guys know I'm a partial owner there. Anyone can become an owner. And some peppers. And then I saw this gorgeous sauce. I was like, oh my gosh, I love you. You're the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. And if you know anything about me, it's because they are soy-free. I'm allergic to soy, mostly soy protein and some fermented soy. So I was really excited to have Asian-inspired sauces. And then I saw this rainbow chard, and it was so pretty, organic. It looks like it just came off the truck today. I was like, this is beautiful. I have to buy this and I have to make something with it. So I did. The veining is so absolutely gorgeous. It was a little bit bitter, but I don't mind that at all. And I remembered that I had one thing of these rice kind of ramen left from like a few months ago when I was really into rice ramen. So I stir fried some veggies together. I also added a little bit of broccoli, and then I tossed it with the sauce and the noodles. It was super simple. It came together in probably like 15 minutes at the most. And then I added my tilapia that I just put some spicy seasoning on and some sesame oil. And it was out freaking rageous. This night was actually my worship night. Ooh, I messed up that cord. Did you guys see that? They probably didn't call me out, but they've been helping me learn to play piano, and we just sing worship songs together, and we have these shirts that we wear. This one is the Alto Energy shirt. It says, when they go high, we go low, because, you know, sopranos go high and altos do the lower part. And then the sopranos have a soprano supremacy shirt, and it says, when we lead, they follow, because sopranos sing the lead and altos follow along, creating those harmonies. So those are just our fun shirts. I actually had left these up on Teespring and some of you guys bought them, which I thought was really funny. I don't have them up anymore, but we just sing together. We pick usually 5 or 6 songs and we sing, and it's so fun and so soul filling. I am so glad that quarantine brought this little gift, because it's not something that we ever would have had before quarantine, because everyone's lives were so busy. So it was a fun night, and the next morning my imperfect produce box came. I guess it's Imperfect Foods now, and they sent me the most random box. Like, I did not order these tomatoes, but I'm glad they're here because I'll definitely use them. I also got this cranberry juice, which I don't drink juice typically, but I'm sure I can use it for some like sparkling water spritzers. They also sent some eggs, which, great, I can always use eggs, but I also had just bought eggs in my grocery pickup, so I have a lot of eggs to go through right now. And this is the part where I'm getting confused. I'm like looking at the order notes and I'm like, did they just give me someone else's box? And this has happened a couple of times so far. They sent ground turkey, which also did not order. Some Tillamook cheese, which I'll use. Who doesn't love some Tillamook cheese? And actually this cheese isn't that bad on points. I checked. Jeez, they gave me so much random stuff. Guys, I literally only ordered sweet potato and cod, which they must have been out of both because there's no sweet potato in here and no cod. This happened like 2 weeks ago too. They were out of the eggs that I ordered and out of the green beans that I ordered. And they sent like, oh, there's more stuff back here. Wow. They had, oh, another cucumber. Great. I love cucumbers. They had sent like a pumpkin spice latte. Actually, I still have it all in my fridge. A pumpkin spice latte. What is this? Chicken broth. And yeah, that's it. Okay. I'm thankful for all the things that they gave me. That's super great that since they were out of stuff, they just subbed in like what they had extra and what probably would have went to waste. So I need more eggs always. I'm glad I got eggs. Of course, who isn't thankful for a ball of mozzarella. So that was my real-time reaction to that. But Imperfect Foods is celebrating 5 years, which is crazy because I helped launch in Austin, which was over 4 years ago. So it's amazing to see them growing, and I don't fault them for not sending me the right things. I'm thankful for everything that they send. And the last time they sent me this, and they sent this, and they gave me some zucchini too, which was super nice because who doesn't? Well, I love zucchini. I'm sure other people don't like zucchini. And they sent me some other stuff too. Oh, they sent chicken thighs and like a bunch of random things. But anyhow, my box actually came pretty early that day, so I was having coffee right after. I got sent over a few bags of coffee from Black Coffee, no sugar, no cream. They're a Black owned roast to order coffee business, and I thought it was so cool, and I just love the names of the coffee. I made my iced coffee with Hella Black today, and Black Coffee No Sugar No Cream did give me a discount code. It's just Edyn20. And if you're starting to do holiday shopping, I hope that you'll consider spreading your dollar and supporting Black-owned businesses. This isn't sponsored at all. I just like to support Black-owned businesses if I can, and the coffee is so freaking good. Their business name, oh my gosh, it's like throwback to my childhood, Black Coffee No Sugar No Cream. But it was very, very good. I used caramel syrup in it that day, and I also wanted to use up the eggs I had in the fridge since I got more eggs from Imperfect Produce, and I put one slice of Havarti in here. It was the light Havarti from Trader Joe's, and some seasoning, and then I had it with some greens, some sour cream, a little bit of green onion on top, and my coffee from Black Coffee No Sugar No Cream. So I hope that you guys will support them and support more Black businesses heading into the holidays. Here is a peek of my plants. I know around the beginning of quarantine, I showed my plants all the time, but now they're all just really thriving and there's no propagating going on. But around Christmas, I am gonna do some repotting. That's one of my first propagated plants. Look how full it is. This one's super full. This one, you guys helped me resurrect from the dead, and I was bottom watering both of those two plants. And this one's sprouting all kinds of new leaves all the time. So is this one. Look at that baby sprout. And I was trying to zoom in on this tiny little leaf that's popping out right now, but I couldn't get my camera to focus. But my plants are doing so good. For lunch that day, I had some halibut, and I just breaded it to make my grown-up fish sticks, and I had it with some ranch and buffalo sauce, and it was super good. And I finished the day off by watching this handsome guy. I tried to get him through the screen while I was showing you guys my plants, but I couldn't see him. So here he is in all of his adorableness. Thank you guys so, so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this vlog. And until next time, remember to keep an open mind, keep an open heart, practice unconditional compassion, but don't take shit from anyone. I love you guys endlessly, and I hope you love yourselves even more. There's another little lady over there. I'll talk to you guys really soon. Bye. Never thought it would be so hard. I grew up without a scar. Just living my life with no big worries. And I've always known what I want. Just didn't know what came along. Finding myself a much less happy. Back in the days I used to dream about one day, a life so amazing. Not everyone judges.